Hi folks, I'm Ian Baker with Camping World, and today we're going to go over the 2018 Mallard M33. This is an awesome bunk unit. You have big dual opposing slides here in the main living area, which allows for this beautiful center island. So if you're looking for a big bunk model with a lot of kitchen storage, this is one you definitely want to pay attention to. And let's start off right on this gorgeous island. And you know, this is one of the great things about having the dual opposing slides, as I mentioned, is it allows for this because it really opens this space up and it gives you a lot of extra prep space. You know, you have the side on both sides of the sink here. You have the nice large sink. If you take a look, this is beautiful stainless steel bowl here. One big sink, which I really like if you have like residential size pots and pans, makes them a lot easier to actually set down in there. Pull out faucet also makes it super easy to wash and rinse those. If we take a quick look underneath here, look at that. You have plenty of room there for a trash can, which is awesome. This is personally where I would want it underneath my sink, you know. You're done, just toss stuff right under there. And then you still have the other side for like some of your chemicals, cleaning supplies, things like that. If we take a look on the side, you'll see there's an electrical outlet here. You have one on the other side as well. But even more impressive is right underneath that, and that is the central vac. That's something you'll find in almost every Mallard, and I love the fact they put that in there. It really makes cleaning a lot easier because far too often, you don't have a spot to put like a big vacuum. So this makes it super simple. You just take the hose, plug it in right there, and you can clean up your trailer area, your living area here nice and easily. In the kitchen slide right here, you will see up top, you have a nice little cutout. You know, it's very easy to reach any items in there. Directly underneath that, your Dometic fridge freezer combo. You can see that. You have a cutout there too for if you have some taller items like a half gallon of orange juice, something like that. This unit does run off both propane and electric and also has automatic switchover. Moving over a little further, you have your microwave right here. Underneath that is your hood with a light and fan. Then directly underneath that is your three burner cooktop. It is recessed and they give you this glass cover. So again, you have this as extra prep space, which is great. When you want to cook, it's nice and simple. You just fold this up and back. That will give you access to your three burner cooktop. And also this doubles as a backsplash. You'll see there's this really pretty backsplash behind it, but again, that's more decorative. This is way easier to clean. So if you do get like bacon grease and stuff on there, no worries. But as I did mention, three burner cooktop here, the front one is high output. And then right underneath you have an oven in case you want to do some baking. If we take a look underneath, this guy drops down. Look at that, awesome spot for some pots and pans down there, big extra storage. And then as we come over a little bit further, you know, I would probably use this for pantry. You can see that you have a big storage there. Again, if you want to put pots and pans in here, you can do that too, because this is a nice tall door there. And then you have a bank of three full extension ball bearing drawers running all the way down, which is cool. You can see that right there. Plenty of room for your silverware and all your larger utensils, like your spatula, serving spoons, things like that. You'll also notice you have a window here to let in some natural light. Directly underneath, you have an LED light and an electrical outlet, which I really like that placement too, because this is probably where I'd want to put my coffee maker, and I can plug it in right up top there, so it's always plugged in. And then up top here, you have some additional storage. Notice it is strut supported on the overhead door here, so that way it's easy one-hand operation. If we take a look across the way here, this is the other slide. Again, as I mentioned, this is our main living area. So the thing I like about this is your super slide with a U-dinette. The reason I like a U-dinette in bunk models, you know, it's not that you can sit a ton more people around them, because realistically, you'll still get about four people in a U-dinette. But the bigger issue is the fact it makes a much larger bed. So if you have additional guests, this table drops down here. It's nice and simple. You just remove the legs out of the flange in the floor as well as the flange in the table here. The table itself will sit along these rails. You can see that. You'll then take the back cushions, these two right here as well as this one in the back, put it on top, and that will create a nice large bed where two adults can sleep. There's also an electrical outlet down there. So if you need to plug in like a laptop or tablet, maybe you're one of the lucky people that get to work while you're on the road, which is a great lifestyle, I envy you. But you are able to plug in right there and still sit at the table. Both the light right up top here as well as the wall sconces are LED. That's something that you don't see very often either. Most manufacturers just have incandescents here. And I don't understand why. In all honesty, these are probably two of the most used lights besides in the kitchen right here. And, you know, if you're out boondocking, normally those incandescents will just drain your battery. So having LED on both of these, to me, is a pretty big deal. You'll see you have windows all the way around here as well to let in a lot of natural light, which is great. Right down here is your tri-fold sofa. So we talk about sleeping space. Not only is this tri-fold extremely comfortable, you see you have built-in armrests here, which is awesome, but this also folds out into a very comfortable bed. It's nice and simple to do. Basically, you remove these two cushions here. They're Velcroed on. This bottom part lifts up and folds out. Then this back cushion right here folds down. And take a look at this cushion. You can see how thick it is. This is what your guests get to sleep on. They have an actual comfortable bed. They're not going to have a big bar in their back or an air mattress that's going to deflate on them. So definitely the preferred type of sleeper sofa in an RV. Right up top here, you have some additional storage. Nice decorative glass on there. Again, same thing. It has the struts for easy one-hand operation. LED light here as well. If we take a look right up front, this is the entertainment center. So on that rainy day, you know, when you want to sit and hang out and watch some TV, this is a great spot to do it. The thing I love about this is a huge opening. This is a pretty big travel trailer, especially if you're sitting in the U-dinette and you don't want just like a dinky 19-inch TV. You want something you're actually gonna be able to see. And this gives you the space to be able to put that in. Also, you see these audio video connections right here. Those are connected to your multimedia center because this unit's not only a radio and CD player, but also a DVD player. So you can pop a movie in there, connect these to your TV, be able to watch a movie nice and easy. And trust me, people, on a rainy day, you know, I know with my kids, if I can pop some Frozen in, my daughter is happy. So, you know, definitely a lifesaver again on those rainy days. You also notice you have storage right up top here. Nice decorative glass there. And then you have a little cubby hole right here. You can see you have some connections in there, electrical outlet as well for some of your auxiliary equipment, and then some additional storage right down below here. The last thing I do want to mention is if we take a quick look at the ceiling, one, you'll see it is a ducted AC here with a quick dump. So if you are loading or unloading, you can simply open this up and have all the air dump right into here, cooling it down very quickly. Close that off, and then it will go through your channel ductwork. The other thing is the ceiling itself. If you notice, you have a crowned interior ceiling. That is phenomenal for a couple reasons. One, it makes it a lot more open. You know, you don't feel closed in and claustrophobic. And two, both the inside and outside roof have a radius to it, so you have more even insulation throughout your center area here. You know, so I do like the fact it's a lot more even, especially going out to the edges. And, you know, when you have a curved roof and then a flat ceiling, you know, you kind of have the low spots on the edges. Not the case here. So definitely a big bonus in the Mallard. Right outside the bunk room here, you'll see you have some nice versatile storage. So we open up both the doors. You see on one side, you have nice big wardrobe area, place to hang the kids' clothes. Over to this side, you have some options here. If you want to hang up more clothes, you can certainly do that, as these shelves here are removable. Or you can put folded clothes here, or if you want, you can even use this as a linen closet, seeing as how it is straight across from the bathroom. Speaking of the bathroom, take a quick look at the door. One of the things I like they did is, you know, again, it's sometimes the little things that manufacturers do. I like the fact they put a little decoration on the door. It's not so plain, you know, just helps kind of take it to that next level, just make it look a lot nicer. As we open up the bathroom here, right in the corner, you have your foot flush lever toilet there. Plenty of leg room all the way around, good shoulder room as well. You also have the heat duct right there, you can see, which is cool. So if it's a cold morning, it'll keep you nice and toasty. A door there too. This is a second entrance. This is really nice because, you know, it's a bunk unit. If kids want to come in and use the bathroom, they can do that. They don't have to traipse dirt throughout the whole RV. And so it is just nice and convenient. Over to this side here, you will see your mirrored medicine cabinet. And then right down below that is a sink top and vanity with some additional storage underneath. Then over to the side, right over here, is a tub shower. I personally like having a tub shower in a bunk unit because if you have smaller kids, you may still want to give them a bath, and you can do that in the Mallard here. You also notice you have a hand wand for easy showering. Up top, you have a big skylight, which gives you additional headroom and lets in some natural light. And then along the corner, you have some shelves. The bunk room in the M33 has three beds. The top one right over here folds up to get out of the way, give you access to the couch there. See, it's a teddy bear bunk series, so it's nice and comfortable. 200-pound weight limit on this one, and as I mentioned, it does just lift up, and then you can move this over and lock it into place. You'll want to do that on both sides. But underneath here, you have the what's commonly known as like a cube-style bed or sofa. And this is really cool because if you have larger kids, you know, maybe they're 16 and 6'2" or whatever it may be, you're able to sleep larger kids here. And this can also sleep two kids as well, which is neat. The backrests both have cup holders. It actually has two cup holders here, which is great, so you can set some beverages in there. You know, if you want, you can even set them on the floor here, and they can kind of put the their pop or juice or whatever in there. I just kind of like those. And then this will fold out just like so, and as I said, both of these will fold out, creating that nice large bed space here on the floor. If it's a rainy day and you know you want to have some electronics while you're camping, right across the way here is where you'd hook those up. So you can put a nice big TV in there, just like the living room. It's a very large opening. You have storage on both sides here. I'll open that up so you can see different storage. On the one, you have shelves, again, for folded kids' clothes. And then this one right here, you can see the hanging rod going across the top. So that way, again, you can hang up some kids' clothes in here. Nice little cutout right there, pretty big if you take a look there. And then you have two full extension ball bearing drawers here underneath. Right up top, you will see the largest of the bunks, or larger of the bunks. This is nice and wide here. 300-pound weight capacity on this one. So, you know, the cool thing about this is if you have two smaller kids that want to climb up here, you can easily fit them, both of them, right up top here. You do have a window right behind me. Lets in a lot of natural light there. There's also an emergency exit. And then right up front here, this is something that's nice too. You have an actual door here on the Mallard M33 rather than a lot of manufacturers which just put in a curtain. The bedroom of the M33 has a queen bed, and on both sides of that bed you have some great storage space there. You see you have the nice nightstand on top. You also have a cubby hole underneath and electrical outlets there as well. So if you need to charge any electronics or plug in a CPAP machine, you have plenty of room in which you can do that. Directly above, you see mirrored wardrobe space, hanging rod going across, additional storage across the top of the bed here, again, the nice decorative glass. But you can see that's actually pretty good storage up there. And then right underneath here on the headboard, you do see you have two LED lights. That way, if you want to read at night, you're able to do that as well. And take a look right over here. This is one of my favorite parts. Now, you know, I talked about that big TV in the living room, but you actually have a swivel mount here, which is great. So you can swivel this right around. You know, again, you can plug this into the TV. If you want to watch a movie, you can watch a movie here at night before you go to bed as well. Now that we've seen the inside, let's take a quick look at some of the outside features on the Mallard M33. Starting right up front here, you have your two 20-pound propane tanks with your cover. Nice and easy to get to those tanks. Just undo these two thumb screws here, lift up the door, and that will give you access down and in. Right behind that, you see rails here for your battery. Notice that it is wide enough you can fit two batteries here if you desire to have a second one. And then right over here, you have a light in case you need some extra light if you're hooking up or disconnecting at night. Then over on the other side, you have solar prep. So if you like to do a lot of boondocking, you just want to make sure your battery's topped off, just give it that little trickle charge. All you have to do is buy the portable Furion panel, plug it in, and it will trickle charge your battery. Directly up above that, you have the black diamond plating here, which helps protect the front end from some of the rocks and debris that will get thrown up by your tow vehicle. And then you have the beautiful front cap here. Not only does this look great, it also helps with some of your insulation values. You know, and it'll stay nice looking like that. You can see the luster and shine it has in there. You also have some LED lights built into either side just to give it that cool look at night as well. When we come around to this side here, we have the pass-through storage. Couple quick things. One, it is slam latch, and these are good slam latches. They actually work. You know, each and every time you shut it, it's a nice heavy weight here, and it shuts the way it should. You also notice it has a covered hinge on here, so you don't have a bunch of rust coming down your door. It's magnetic, so you can just put it up and forget it. And you'll see it is a nice wide door. So if you have larger items like a grill, which is what you have right here, or some of your bigger chairs, things like that, you can actually fit them in here. So if we take a look again, it's nice and open. You'll see you have a couple LED lights in here. As I mentioned, this is a grill. I'll show you where that goes in a little bit. Hooks up in the back and by your outside kitchen, of course. And then right over here, this is really nice too. This one does have your power stabilizer jack. So one of these, this top one here will control your front. The bottom one here will control the rear. Large power awning on here as well. Just push a button to have that roll out. Same thing to have it go right back in. It does have an adjustable pitch on there. So, you know, if you need the rainwater to run one way or the other, you can go ahead and adjust that. It also has an LED light strip under there, so you don't have to get up and hang up your Christmas lights if you don't want to. Just flip a switch and you will have light at night. Two sets of stairs into the M33. This is your main one right here leading into your living area. The other one is in the back, which goes into the bathroom. If we, you can't really see it, but underneath, one of the things I do like about the Mallard as well is you can camp into the later seasons. You know, this one does have a fully enclosed and heated underbelly. So if you're looking to camp when it starts to dip below freezing, not a problem. As long as you're running the furnace inside, it'll ensure that your tanks and everything underneath won't freeze up on you. Beautiful sidewall exteriors. They are fully laminated, 2-inch sidewalls, again, for that nice insulation if you are camping in the colder season. If we take a look at the tires here, the wheels, you'll see that they're aluminum alloy wheels, which are great. Not only do they look really nice, but they also won't rust on you, less chance for any kind of corrosion. Nitrogen-filled tires, so hopefully they hold that pressure for a longer period of time, which is important. You always want to check your tire pressure before each and every trip, no matter what RV you have. You'll also see that they're spread apart. This is what they call the wide track suspension or a spread axle system, which helps with your towability. It helps reduce the sway while going down the road. Right outside here, you have an electrical outlet. If you need to plug anything in, that's the place you're going to do it. If you like to listen to music, you will see on the slide right here, you have two outside speakers. Those are connected to your multimedia center inside. However, that unit is Bluetooth capable. So if you want to hang out here underneath your awning and be able to control your music from your smart device, you can do that. Right over here is a black tank flush. This is super convenient when you're done camping. Rather than having to take a hose into your bathroom and sticking it down your toilet to wash out your black tank, you simply hook it up right here. That black tank has sprayers built in and it will wash it out for you. Second entrance right here, same thing as the first. You do have 3 steps there, folds out nice and easily. And then right here in the back, this is one of my favorite parts about a bunk model, and that is the outside kitchen. And the Mallard, in my opinion, has nailed it. I love this setup. A couple different reasons. First of all, you have great prep space right here. And if that's not enough, you actually have this pull-out space here as well. So, you know, when you're prepping your food, maybe you're, you know, getting your meat ready, putting some spices on it, whatever it may be, you have all this extra space. I think that is phenomenal. You also have a sink right over here, which is plumbed in, so this is super easy to use. Right above that, excellent storage. You know, I need a place to put my solo cups, my paper plates. You know, this is an excellent spot for it right there. You have the cool wall board on here, just gives it that nice, almost rustic look and feeling. Of course, an LED light there as well. A smaller TV, but this is perfect. This is all I need. You know, I don't need a TV that takes up the majority of my outdoor kitchen. This is great. I can set up here, can watch the game, you know, put something on. Again, I love that. And my other part that I really like is this right here, the fact that they do give you the larger refrigerator. You know, again, this is probably my favorite part of having the outside kitchen is this right here. This is where I'm going to be putting, you know, my beer, the kids' pop, juice, condiments, you know, your ketchup, mustard, things like that. That is where, you know, again, that's the thing I really enjoy. Then right over here, full extension ball bearing drawer. When I camp, I use plastiware, so this is where I'd be putting all that. But, you know, if you like to use silverware, you can certainly put that in there too. Making our way around the back. So when we were up front, I talked about a grill. This is where that grill mounts to. It has a swing arm on here, nice and easy. Pull this pin. This will swing out and around. So again, you want to prep your food right there, throw it on the grill. You can have that right out here. And you will see underneath you have a propane quick connect where that hooks up to. So that way you can use your big 20-pound bottles instead of having to bring the small little green ones. Right on the back here is an outside shower. You know, as you saw, that sink was stationary. So if you need to, you know, wash the dog or wash your feet off, something like that, you have the outside shower with here with both hot and cold water access, so it is nice and easy to accomplish that. Cable inlet right here, city water inlet right next to that. And then right over here is your spare tire. Hopefully you never have to use this, but in the event that you do, it's a great peace of mind knowing it's riding right back here. It's super easy to get to, and it has the cover, which should ensure that it'll be in nice shape when you go to use it. If you take a look up top there, right above the Mallard, you see the backup camera prep. Again, this is something that is very convenient. It's a pretty decent size RV. And if you're looking to have that extra vision, that visibility when you're backing up, having the prep there will make it a lot less expensive to have that camera installed. On the off-door side here, you'll see your terminations are nice and easy to get to. They're behind your axle, so you know, toward the rear of the coach, which is where you want your terminations. Both your black and gray valves are right there. Right up top here is a 50 amp detachable power cord. This one has a 50 amp because it is actually pre-wired for a second AC. So if you do like to camp in areas where it's really warm and you want to make sure this coach stays cool, you can have that second AC installed. All right, folks, that wraps it up. Again, this is a 2018 Mallard M33. Thanks for watching. I'm Ian Baker, and let's go camping.